The guests, please rise. Guests, please be seated. Who gives Dianna Brubacher to be married to Ryan Fowler?
We do.
Thank you. This afternoon, we have met for a really special reason. We're here to witness a Christian marriage between Ryan and Dianna, and so glad that you came to support them in this. If you're family, relatives, friends, whatever your connection is, it is a big deal to be here. It encourages them, and you will be witnessing a Christian marriage, and their desire is to do this, to glorify Jesus in their lives. So what a privilege it is. And just to remind us that God instituted marriage in Genesis 2. It speaks of that, how that God saw fit to take a rib from Adam and from that rib make a woman for Adam to have a companion in life. And that's where the beginning of a unity between a man and a woman began. And so we're confident this is what God wants for them today. So what a privilege that is. So before we go further in the ceremony, I'd like to just commit this service to the Lord. So let's pray. Father, this afternoon we have met to remind ourselves that you are holy, you are awesome, you're the one true God, creator of the universe. You created man, woman. You did your creation so that it could be used to glorify you. And I just pray for Ryan and for Dianna and the parents, that today as they make their vows to each other, that they would know that they are fulfilling your will and that you would be with them in a special way through this ceremony. And Father, we want your name to be glorified. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for being that great representative of what true love is by laying down your life for us. What an amazing thing. So we commit this ceremony to you in the powerful name of Jesus. Amen. So I'm going to have a brief meditation. And if I were to title it, I'd just call it Heavenly Wisdom. And for marriage, we need heavenly wisdom. For doing life, we need heavenly wisdom. So I'm not speaking on the one word love as such. So if you're not happy with that, it's too late. So anyways, the scripture reading I'm taking it from is actually from James 3 and several verses. So just listen while I read those. Who is wise and understanding among you? Let him show it by his good life, by deeds done in humility that comes from wisdom. But the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure, then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere. Peacemakers who sow in peace raise a harvest of righteousness. So as I mentioned before, I'm not speaking on the word love as such, but I hope you will see that wisdom encompasses love. So what is this basic meaning of wisdom? Well, it involves intelligence, being sensible, full of reason, understanding, and having good insight. I think that sounds like a really good person to get married to. So I'm just encouraging you to take that seriously. And then beyond that, in the Greek, it means to have understanding, knowledge, and a holy love for the will of God. That is a powerful statement, a holy love for the will of God. Notation here is that wisdom is not only intellectual, but it includes behavioral actions. Words and actions that come out of wisdom must be exercised in humility, according to verse 13. Words of wisdom bring goodness and conversation. They are words that inform and carry healing and result in peace. In verse 17, there are powerful words that describe wisdom of being first pure. Pure in the sense of not being devious, not exaggerating or distorting, not self-focused, but other-focused. In other words, pure in motive and truly interested in enhancing the person that they're speaking to. So whether it is talking about others in your conversation, your leisure activities, maybe your finances, wisdom will be always the part of your life that will bring peace, and it will also not be manipulative. Wow, I've said a lot in a few minutes, right? So lest you be discouraged, just remember that God is the one that enables you to do these things. So Ryan, Dianna, you know there's areas in your lives, we've met a number of times, and that you'll be tempted to be self-focused. I just know that. I experienced that in my life. And we have tendencies in certain areas to do that. So really, if you have heavenly wisdom, we really don't have an excuse as such, or at least you shouldn't be acting on it. But that's a high call. Another one in heavenly wisdom is peace-loving. This follows pure. The idea here is to bring calm and restore peace. So if you mess up, you will, and you will. So the first thing to do is to be wise and do the thing that's good and bring words of affirmation and acceptance. Heavenly wisdom is also easily entreated. So that makes it easy, Dianna, for you to approach Ryan and for Ryan to approach you. That's how it should be if we have the peace-loving part of heavenly wisdom. Next comes to be considerate. That's being attentive and thoughtful and actively listening by asking caring and kind questions to gain mutual understanding. Remember, communication is more than just talking. It's mutual understanding. Then the big one is submissive. This comes under the idea of to respect, to honor. In Ephesians 5:21, Paul teaches we need all to submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. This is the overriding principle in everything we do. Why? Because this attitude will bring glory to God. Paul also teaches that wives are to submit to their husbands, which is also God-honoring. Dianna, this will be much easier for you if Ryan is the godly man, the God-fearing man, the humble person, servant leader that he can be in your home. Ryan, this gives no room for your ego, and I'm sorry about that, but very little room for ego, pride. These are powerful words, and we'll never get it perfectly right. What I'm saying today is these are the high set bars for us in life as we walk with God. So let's keep that in mind. And then full of mercy. This is another form of what I will say love. The recipient may not be deserving at the moment from actions being done, but mercy moves towards that person who is in need. Your spouse may not be responding as positively as you'd like. So for example, Dianna, you struggle with being punctual or one of those things that happen in life. Ryan may have to exercise mercy. It could be that we have a bit of fear or anxiety or other actions that require a moving towards with words and actions that bring healing and encouragement rather than criticism. Showing mercy is a powerful way of saying, I love you, I care for you. Then it's good fruit, and we can't develop this. We know Galatians 5:22 has words like love, joy, peace, long-suffering, and gentleness, goodness, and all kinds of things. And that's just the activity of the Holy Spirit being active in our lives, these are the qualities that should come forward. Impartial. Wow, that's a loaded one. We all have partialities. So being unbiased, the objective is to be fair-minded. There are traps along the way in marriage where we have partialities. It can be in our domestic activities, our leisure activities, the way we do Christmas, maybe certain ways we do finances. There's things that we can have partialities with. So be careful. Try to keep a good approach. Sincere, free from pretense. Jesus is the ultimate example of not having pretense. He was pure in all his ways. The scriptures say he was full of grace and truth. So in summary, Ryan and Dianna, if you take time to apply God's gift of heavenly wisdom in your marriage, you will exercise a richer and more meaningful life serving God together and allowing Christ to be Lord. And you know what the promise is at the end? The result is a harvest of righteousness. A harvest of righteousness. This is fall. It's great to see the crops go in and to see a harvest of righteousness. So, do you, Ryan Fowler, and you, Dianna Brubacher, understand that you're committing yourselves to one another for the rest of your lives? That God expects both of you to selflessly care for and love for one another? And do you recognize you will sometimes fail to live up to those qualities that are mentioned in Scripture? That you will need to practice forgiveness? Do you sincerely and reverently enter the marriage relation determined to abide in purity, patience, and love with each other? If you do, the bridegroom will answer with, "We do." So if you're ready to assume the obligations and duties as I've kind of briefly defined them for married life, I would like you have your hands united already, so that's good. You're ready for the vows. So you will give to consent to your marriage vows, and
Dianna, before God and these witnesses, I take you to be my wedded wife and to be your partner in life. I promise to love you, honor, and keep you for better or for worse, for rich or poor, in sickness and in health. I promise to love you faithfully, forsaking all others for as long as we both shall live.
Ryan, before God and these witnesses, I take you to be my wedded husband and to be your partner in life. I promise to love you, honor you, and keep you, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health. I promise to love you faithfully, forsaking all others for as long as we both shall live.
The bride and groom will now exchange their rings.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my unending love and a commitment to you as long as we both shall live.
Ryan, I give you this ring as a symbol of my unending love and a commitment to you as long as we both shall live.
So be it known unto all who have witnessed this service, to everyone to whom these persons afterwards meet, that as a servant of God, I do now, according to the vows made before me, solemnize, seal, and declare to be forever binding in the holy wedded union of this man and this woman. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and by the laws of the province of Ontario, I pronounce you Ryan Fowler and you Dianna Brubacher, lawfully married husband, wife, With your most solemn vows, you have been united according to the plan of God, so let no human thought or purpose or act ever separate you. The groom may now kiss the bride. Let's have a prayer of dedication for Ryan and Dianna. Father, we stand again amazed that you are the one who has so wisely planned human relationships. And so here we stand and we lift Ryan and Dianna before your holy throne and say, we give them over to you and ask that you would help them walk with you, that they would yield to the Holy Spirit's promptings in their life. They would be rich in your word, to pray, to study together, and to serve together in order that they might have a harvest of righteousness in their life. And their lives would be beautiful for your glory. Lord, protect them from the evil one. Protect them from discouragement. And help them to find comfort in meeting with other Christians and serving you and being a witness in the workplace to speak much of Jesus. We want to be all for you. We pray for this for them in Jesus' name. Amen. So just a couple of announcements so you know what's taking place following the ceremony. So immediately after the ceremony, the parents and the bridal couple will be out in the foyer for a receiving line, so make sure you walk by and they want to say hi to you and make some comments to you, I'm sure. And also there's going to be some drinks you'll see out in the foyer. Feel free to have some of those to refresh yourself with before the reception tonight. Family photos, keep this in mind. After the receiving line, there's going to be family photos that they want to finish off. So don't run away too far for some that aren't in the receiving line so that they can get that done before the reception. The reception is in the gymnasium, next room over, and at 5:30. So if you could be seated by 5:30, would be really appreciated to get the reception started on time. So now, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ryan and Dianna Fowler.
Baby, the sun is shining, dog woods are coming blue. Put on your white dress, yeah, cause a baby, it's a good day for me. I'd call my mom and daddy, baby, you call yours too. Put on your white dress, yeah, cause a baby, it's a good day for me. Means I know what you're thinking, babe. Your friends,
they keep asking
about us.
It's every day passing.
It's time this fairy tale came true. Yeah, cause a baby, it's a good day for marrying you. We got all we need. I'll find a ring if you'll find a shady tree. My friend,
they're all buzzing.
Word's out,
everyone's coming.
Better tell them to bring a preacher too. Baby, the sun is shining, dogwoods are coming in blue. Dress, check calls, baby, it's a good day for me.